Astronomy is the study of the universe, and any description of the universe must acknowledge that it is a rather large place. In fact, you won't find a better description of the size of the universe than in The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy by Douglas Adams. It describes space like this. Space, it says, is big, really big. You just won't believe how vastly, hugely, mind-bogglingly big it is. I mean, you may think it's a long way down the road to the chemist, but that's just peanuts to space. And that is as accurate a description of the size of the universe as anything you'll find in any textbook. But if we're going to make sense of the real sizes of things, we need to be able to quantify them, and we got to use terms other than big and mind-bogglingly big. Let's take, for example, the mass of the sun. Well, in astronomy, we often refer to the mass of the sun as having just one solar mass. Now, this is a very useful way of describing the mass of the sun in relationship to other stars. However, if we want to be able to do things like calculate its gravitational pull on other planets, for example, well, then we need to be able to use units of measurement that we're much more familiar with, such as kilograms. Let's go ahead and show you now the mass of the sun in kilograms, and as you can see, it's a very large number. Now, to say this number in English, I had to look this up on Wikipedia, but this reads as 1,939,000,000,000 kilograms. I never used those terms before and had to look them up. Well, in any case, that's a lot of zeros to have to write out. And moreover, if I make a mistake and misplace just one of those zeros, well, then I've changed the value of the mass of the sun by a whole factor of 10. And that is a major problem. So scientific notation can come to our rescue here. What it does is it takes this very big number and expresses it in a compact form that is not only easier to write, but is error-proof as well, or at least close to error-proof. I mean, I'm not going to accidentally write down 29 when I meant to write down 30. At least for me, I think that would be a hard mistake to make. But the real power of scientific notation comes from this power of 10, this 10 raised to some exponent. And this exponent, we sometimes refer to it as an order of magnitude. A good way to visualize these powers of 10 is to put it in terms of something that we can all understand and relate to. I'm talking about money. So, for example, $1, that'll buy you a candy bar, say a nice Milky Way candy bar. Milky Way. See what I did there? Okay. Anyway, now, if we go up a full power of 10, in other words, if we go from $1 to $10, well, now you can buy yourself a nice book. If we go to two powers of 10, or $100, well, now you can have dinner at a nice restaurant. If you increase to three powers of 10, or $1,000, you can book yourself a nice plane ticket to a pretty cool, distant, remote location. Maybe Rome, Italy, or someplace really cool like that. Now, if you go to four powers of 10, now you're in the market for a new car. Now, I won't say, for example, that every new car costs just $10,000 or 10 to the $4. But what we can say, this, for example, is the Tesla Model 3. Okay, it's going to start at around $40,000, or 4 times 10 to the 4th power. So what this multiple does, what this number 4 does, is it tells us where within that power of 10 ballpark we happen to be. In this case, we're 1, 2, 3, 4 steps into that 10 to the 4th range, but we haven't crossed into the 10 to the 5th range yet. At just one order of magnitude greater, or 10 to the 5th dollars, you could take an extended, luxurious vacation in Italy, or you could buy yourself an apartment, maybe a little villa someplace, and live there. Whatever you decide to do with that kind of money, the point is that in just five powers of 10, we've gone from something that you get out of a vending machine to a life-changing experience. In astronomy, however, we often go with a far greater range of powers of 10. Here are just some going from 10 to the $2 up to 10 to the 12, but that's only 10 powers of 10 difference. We can go far greater than that, as we're about to find out. But for now, let's just remember our rules of thumb for scientific notation. We can take any number and express it as a multiple of a power of 10. And the thing about this multiple is that we can increase the precision as much as we'd like. So in this example, I'm showing you 4.54, which is the same thing as saying, well, in this case, 4,540,000,000. Okay, so by increasing the number of decimal places, we can also increase the precision of our scientific notation value. And when it comes to the multiplier, another rule of thumb that we always follow is to keep that value somewhere between 1 and less than 10. So as long as it's in that range, we're in the same order of magnitude. If we went to a multiple of, say, 10 or 11, well, now we just simply increase our order of magnitude and shift that decimal point back over toward the left to keep it just one digit away from the rest of the decimal places. And the most important thing about this scientific notation is that we're going to let that power of 10 do the heavy lifting for us. So, armed with their knowledge of powers of 10, let's grab our towels, stick out our thumbs, and take a tour of the universe.